Welcome to this Thrive Today series on how do the relational skills address my biggest problems. So my name is Christy Harang. I'm part of the Thrive Today team. And in this series, we're going to be having very short segments of conversations looking at some of the biggest challenges that we might face in life and how the relational skills can help us with those challenges. Today we're tackling parenting, and you know parenting is such a gift, but it is also not an easy job. So we're going to be having a conversation with president and co-founder Chris Corsi to take a look at how the relational skills can help us with our parenting challenges. We hope you enjoy. Okay, so Chris, thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you, Christy. I'm so glad to be here, and I'm excited about our topic today.
Yeah, me too. As a mom, I've got four kids. I guess I can give some context and different age ranges and maturity stages. And I will say parenting has been God's biggest strategy to grow me as a human being. And I'm very invested in learning. And I will say the skills have helped me so much in my parenting. So Chris, let's talk about this because I think as parents, we want to do the best we can for our kids. And yet so often we feel overwhelmed. We have kids who are throwing tantrums or maybe older kids who are back talking or not listening to us. Sometimes I know I can feel like my capacity is all used up and mean mommy starts coming out. I'm like, who is that person? So can you just talk about how the relational skills can help us, for example, in these places of maybe overwhelm?
You know what? Parenting is such a mixed bag because on the one hand, it's so life-changing when you bring home your baby from the hospital or the first night of having a baby. It's amazing. Like, it's just amazing. Parenting is wonderful. But then, as you well said, Christy, there's also those times where we just want to pull our hair out. We are so maxed out. We're so hurt, tired, angry. I mean, you name it, right? The whole enchilada of emotions and feelings here. So I think every loving parent can relate to that, that you love your children more than life itself. And yet sometimes you just want to pull their hair out. Like you know, it's so hard, so frustrating, and so overwhelming. And so why I'm excited about relational skills is, you know what, I like to think of relational skills as our relational life preserver. Relational skills doesn't mean I'm going to do everything perfectly, but what it does mean is that I learn to get back to joy when things go wrong. And that's a hopeful message for all of us, that with a little bit of practice, with some effort, we can learn and strengthen relational skills that help us better stay present, that help us better stay tender with our children's weaknesses. It better helps us be able to navigate those moments when there's a conflict, there's arguments, your children aren't listening, they're doing anything but what you've asked them to do. Relational skills help you to catch your breath. They help you to recognize when you need a timeout, when you need a moment to pause, when you start to lose it, when you can get back to joy yourself from negative emotions, where you can also stay a relational in negative emotions, when you know what you need when things are going wrong. So relational skills really do provide this relational tool belt of tools that we will use day in and day out. You know, parenting is one of the most meaningful things that we'll ever do. And one of the questions I like to ask parents is, I want you to think, you know, when you look back on your life and when you think about raising your children, what is it you want to be able to see, or what is it you want to be able to feel, or what is it you want to be able to say? And odds are very high that joy and love will be part of that answer, that you want your children to know that they were loved and that you enjoy them. And so relational skills help you to be able to live in a way with your family and with your children that you will look back on one day and have peace of mind, not because you've done everything perfectly, but because you've done everything well and you've planted seeds in your children that will grow a bountiful harvest for the rest of their lives.
Yeah, it's one of the things I love about the message you get with Thrive Today is that there's all this hope for growth and development, but there's zero guilt. that comes along with our mistakes. Because like you said, it's not that we do it perfectly. It's that we know how to recover when we do blow it. And I think as parents, we probably all feel guilt at times for ways that we've messed up. And this is just such a message that is hopeful without any of that guilt tied to it, that unhealthy guilt. Chris, how would you also connect in how the skills with everything you shared help us to stay connected to our kids when we are going through the rough stuff, you know, whether they're disobeying or we're frustrated with them, or maybe we just feel disconnected at times?
You know, what I like about relational skills is it helps us to be connected and feel connected with our children. You know, one of the reasons why parenting is so hard, because either we lack the skills, maybe our family just didn't have the skills, so we never picked up the skills along the way, or our pain is stirred up and triggered. So, you know, obviously we come into parenting, we're not perfect. We've had our own scars and our own wounds, and inevitably that stuff is going to get stirred up. And when it gets stirred up, if I don't have the relational skills in place, then I'm going to be like a car that just hit an oil spot, and I'm going to just go out of control very quickly. So, you know, there's some foundational skills that every parent should just have. And one of them is what we call skill zero at Thrive Today. It's just learning to hold on to my relational circuits and to keep my relational brain working. It's not hard to do. It just takes a little bit of practice. And, you know, learning to be able to stay relational or return to relational mode. Just the other day, there was a conflict in our house, and I noticed I was getting really angry with my son, but I knew I needed a breather before I talked to him and tried to work out the situation. So I knew enough to get my relational circuits on. But then there was this other skill, Kristen, where I knew I needed to see him how God sees him in a moment, because I was just focused on the problem, right? So as I was working to get my relational brain back online, I was also able to see some of what God sees in my son. And it just put a smile on my face, seeing some of what God sees. And, you know, in that moment, I was able to better reflect that than I would have otherwise. And I think you said it well, Christy, that, you know, over time, just the mean mom or the mean dad in us does start to come out, basically because, you know, we're often beyond our capacity to handle things. And so relational skills will also help us to grow our capacity so that we suffer well and we stay relational with our children. And one of the big skills that I think is just transformational for parents is learning to get back to joy. When you learn to get back to joy, you don't have to worry about avoiding certain emotions, that you can actually join your children in what they're feeling. And when you get back to joy, you're paving the way for them to get back to joy. And just the skill of recognizing when a breather is needed. Like, we have saved so many train wrecks in our household by just recognizing when one of our sons is like getting, you know, suddenly starting to lose it. You see the look on his face, the tone of his voice, you know that he's about to lose it. Well, it's time to take a pause. It's time to, you know, get some need met before this gets worse. These relational skills you will use every day interacting with your children. And the good news is you will have joy and peace, and that teaches your children joy and peace. So there's just a lot of good stuff here, Christy. I'm so glad that we're having this conversation, because every loving parent just wants to finish well. You know, at the end of the day, we just want to finish well. We want to get back to joy when things go wrong.
Yeah, no, that's so good. And I know even specifically skill zero with getting our relational circuits on, and skill 13 you mentioned with God's sight, those have helped me so much in just enjoying my children. Because I'll be honest, and I think it's a hard thing for parents to say, but I'm going to let you know you're not alone. Sometimes we just don't enjoy them. And I felt a lot of guilt for maybe not even liking my kids at times. And these skills have helped me to really see my children and to love them and enjoy them, even when things are hard, or even when things aren't hard and we're just not, like, I'm just not seeing them. They've helped me to see them and enjoy them, which has been such a game changer for me. So we want to just give you a couple resources if you would like to get some help in building these relational skills and having it impact you in your parenting. Chris mentioned his Joy Switch book. This is fabulous for you learning to get your joy switch on, to get that relational part of your brain going. Parents, I don't know about you, I don't have time to read. This book is, if you're going to read a book, this book is it. It's short. It's easy to read. It's got exercises in it. So I highly recommend it. Even if you're a little bit overwhelmed by reading in this season, this would be a great book to still make an attempt to read. And then we also have Chris's. So this was Chris's release in January. And then he just released a book with Dr. Marcus Warner on 4 Habits of Raising Joy-Filled Kids. And this book is going to be a roadmap for navigating each stage with your child, whether it's the infant stage or the child stage or the adult stage. So both this and the Joy Switch can be found at thrivetoday.org/ourworks. And really, as a parent, I cannot more highly recommend these two books to be in your library. And then we also want to mention that we have online courses where Chris will actually take you through exercises to build your relational skills. You've got a coach right there with you to lead you through these exercises. And if you're noticing, like, I need some help with my anxiety or my frustration or keeping relational, these exercises will be a game changer in your life and in your parenting. And this will help you to be the best parent you can be, to become more relational, less anxious in your parenting. And then you'll be able to spread those skills naturally to your kids because they'll be developed in you. So we hope that you will check out these resources. You can also find these courses at the site below, but also at thrivetoday.org/online courses. So yeah, thank you for joining us. Chris, thank you for just giving us some insight on this short snippet on parenting. And we look forward to seeing you at a future Thrive event or one of our online courses.